Everybody asked me how I know. I smiled at them and said she told me so fine. Everybody asked me how I know. I smiled at them and said she told me so fine.
Hi guys, and welcome back to the ARK Online. My name is Craig Scott. I am the family ministry leader here at Bethany Church. I'm so glad you've joined us this morning. As you can see, I'm not in the usual studio. Unfortunately, me and Jodi have had to isolate this week, not because we've had the COVID, but just because we wouldn't need someone who did. No cameras, no fancy audio equipment, just me, Jodi, the phone, and Jean's managed to do her story later on. Oh, wonder what we're going to be learning about. I bet it's Daniel again. I bet it's the second part of Daniel. I bet you that's what it is. But anyway, let's find out what we're learning about from our good old friend, our Bob. Are you ready to shout for him? Our Bob! Our Bob! Come and press this big red button!
Roll it, Jeffrey! My name's Bob and I like to press the button to find out above what we're learning on today's ARK Online. I'm gonna press that button now. We're gonna have a lot of fun and find out what we're learning about today on the ARK Online.
I'm gonna press this button now. Ha! Ow!
That hurt. Daniel, Nebuchadnezzar's dream.
2 years after rising to the throne of Babylon, King Nebuchadnezzar had a terrible dream. This dream frightened him so much that he couldn't sleep. King Nebuchadnezzar, in anguish and desperate to learn what the dream meant, called in all the wise men known to him to see if any of them could interpret his dream. The wise men came before King Nebuchadnezzar and asked him to tell them about his dream. But the king refused. King Nebuchadnezzar demanded that the wise men first tell him what he dreamed, and then what the dream meant. The king declared, "If you can do this, I will give you great rewards. If not, I will have you put to death." In disbelief of the king's request, the wise men said, "King Nebuchadnezzar, what you ask is impossible. No one can do what you ask. Only a god could tell you your dream." This made King Nebuchadnezzar so angry that he ordered that all his wise men be put to death, including Daniel and his friends Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. When the king's chief soldier, Arioch, came to capture Daniel, he asked Arioch what was going on. Arioch explained the situation, and Daniel went to King Nebuchadnezzar to ask for time to interpret the dream. The king agreed, and Daniel hurried back to see Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego so that they could pray for God's help. That night, God revealed to Daniel the king's dream and its meaning. The next morning, Daniel went to Arioch and said, "Don't execute the wise men of Babylon. I will interpret the king's dream." When Arioch brought Daniel before King Nebuchadnezzar, the troubled, tired king asked Daniel, "Can you tell me what I saw in my dream?" Daniel replied, "No one could tell you this, but there is a God in heaven who reveals mysteries. He showed me your dream and what it means." Daniel told the king, "God showed you the future through your dream. In your dream, you saw a statue with a head of gold, chest and arms of silver, belly and thighs of bronze, legs of iron, and feet of iron mixed with clay. Then a rock smashed the statue. The rock became a mountain that filled the whole earth. You, king, are the head of gold, and every other part of the statue are the kingdoms that will come after you. The rock represents a kingdom that God will establish that will last forever." King Nebuchadnezzar bowed before Daniel and showed him great honor for all that God had spoken through him. The king said, "Surely your God is the God of gods and the Lord of kings, the one who can reveal the greatest of mysteries." For his service, King Nebuchadnezzar promoted Daniel to a high position and placed him in charge of all the wise men. At Daniel's request, the king also promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to rule over all the provinces of Babylon.
Name that Bible character!
I baptize Jesus in the River Jordan. Who am I?
Name that Bible character!
Jodi's here. It's memory verse time. We're doing the memory verse outside.
It's coming home. It's coming home.
Get in. It's ooh, coming on, guys. Nice one. Nice. I like it.
Nice.
Anyway, back to the memory verse. We've got another fantastic memory verse for you. And it comes from the book of James. And it reads,
If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give it to you. James 1, verse 5.
Boom! Nice, nice. Well, Jodi, we're out in the garden.
Actions.
Out in the garden, isolating. Need some actions from you.
I'm in my garden.
Nope.
I'll do what I want.
Nope.
actions for this, please.
All right.
Right, so.
If you do not have wisdom.
I want wisdom.
I want wisdom teeth.
Oh, wisdom teeth, okay.
Wisdom.
Wisdom.
Ask God for it.
Oh, nice.
He is
always ready.
Always ready.
All right, so he's like getting ready. He's always ready to give it to you.
James. James.
James. 1 verse 5.
Boom.
Boom. Nice. Let's put it all together. So,
ready?
If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give it to you.
James. 1 verse 5.
Boom. Nice. Well done, Jodi. Good one.
Yep.
Buy them birds aloud, aren't they? Shut up, birds. Right. What week is it, Jodi? It is Memory Verse. England football match week.
It's coming.
Well, we're filming this on Friday. Kids might be watching on Sunday, so they might be anticipating, might be waiting for the final on Sunday. Or they could be watching it in the future, and they'll either know if we won or lost. Hopefully it came home, but if it didn't, oh well.
We got to the final.
Yeah.
We got to the final.
It did us proud. It did us very proud. So, because of that, we're going to do some actions that involve footballs and...
Who are you going with?
I'll go with the boys.
Girls. And I go first.
You get to go first. Carry on.
Because I'm in the garden, there's a football.
Whoa.
So, you're going to be my partner because you're going to have to count how many of these I do. So you just need your palm of your hand.
Right. Just like keep you ups with your hand.
Just with your hand.
Right.
Ready?
Okay.
You count.
Right, okay.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, girls.
If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it.
He is always ready to give it to you. James 1, verse 5.
23. Well done. Oh, boom! Nice one, Jodi. Well done. Okay, so I'm wearing white. You're wearing red. England was wearing white.
Denmark was wearing red.
That means I can beat you just to see me England beat Denmark again in the final.
Always a challenge with you.
Yeah, it is. It's always a challenge. So I'm going to give this
a
try. Right, you want to try?
Yep. So how many did I do?
Get up. 23.
Right, okay.
So boys, get a ball. Get ready to read the memory verse. Well, keep it up with your hands. So here we go. If you do...
Stop.
What?
You started a few before.
All right, okay. Here we go. If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give it to you. Give 1 verse 5.
23?
Oh, there's a draw? Man. Good thing I could have done a couple more there. I was doing a bit slow. Yeah, well done. Well done. Yeah.
Good game.
Oh. Boom!
Second one.
Go for it.
So, this is not a count you want more. Don't count them.
Because I'm not very good at it.
I'm just going to do headers.
One.
And catch them.
Two.
Ready? Ready, girls?
Yep.
1, 2, 3. If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give it to you. James 1, verse 5.
Ooh.
Boom.
Well, what I'm going to try and do is try and do kick-ups with my feet
right. The
whole time I'm reading. This could go wrong. So, boys, get a ball. Wait there. Boom! We've got a boom for you. Silly. Right, are you ready? 3, 2, 1, boys, get the ball. I'm going to do it. 3, 2, 1. If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give you it. Give it. Oh! Concentrate, I can't remember. Give it to you. James 1 verse 5. Boom! Nice, Jodi, nice. Awesome. Well done. What are we going to do for a joint challenge?
We've won.
Oh, so we're going to
celebrate.
So we're going to celebrate.
Yeah.
Right, so we're going to pretend like we won. If you're watching in the future, just pretend we won, even if we didn't. So here we go, are you ready? Run around screaming, yes! Here we go, 3, 2, 1. If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give it to you.
Yes!
Yes! James won! First five! What happened there? Oh. Yes, we won, Jodi!
Boom!
Boom! Oh, you know what, Jodi? That was a fantastic, fantastic memory verse. England football match week! Well done, Jodi. Well done. Good challenge.
Well done. Well done. Oh, sorry. I've normally got the camera there so I can see.
Nice, that was sweet. So remember, guys, remember, guys, if you do any of the challenges, do the actions, just read the memory verse, remember to take a picture, take a video,
send it in.
Now we can't shout here, Jodi, so I have to get closer because
the
neighbours are out. But if you send it in to us, you never know, you could be on next week's episode of This Is Awesome! Nice one, guys. Right, we'll have a song.
Roll it!
You heard the story by my friend King Dave. Wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me my sling, cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan? Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. They said throw him to the den of the scary beast, but God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. Yeah! My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. History, you will do the same for me, like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. The king of me.
Hi everyone, today we're into our second story about Daniel. Oh, he's about 20 years old now, and it's Daniel and King Nebuchadnezzar's dream. I love it when I remember what I dream about. Do you? Sometimes I remember as soon as I wake up, but within seconds it's gone. I forget it. And I sometimes wake up before the end of a dream and I wonder what was going to happen to next. Sometimes, if it's a bad dream, I'm pleased I can't remember. But I love it if it's been a nightmare. And just that feeling, oh, it was just a dream, don't panic, it's gone. That's the best feeling in the world. There's quite a few dreams and dreamers in the Bible. Maybe some of you can look them up and see how many. My favourites are the Josephs. Joseph in Egypt and Mary and Joseph in the Christmas story. There's quite a lot of dreams there. You see, this king's dreams were like those ones. It was a special dream. It's a dream that God sent him. It's a dream that when God's got something to tell someone, he does it in a dream. Except this king had no idea what the dream meant. This dream, it was turned out to be a bit of a nightmare for him. He couldn't get back to sleep, nor how. It kept him up all night. So he says to his wise guys, his advisors, the magicians, the astrologists, and the mind readers, he says to them, I want you to tell me what that dream meant. Now, sometimes dreams are just that, just dreams. This one was from God. It felt different from all the rest. It was a message. Of course, said the wise guys, tell us what it was about, Your Majesty, and we'll tell you what it means. Wink, wink. They could have said anything, couldn't they? They could have just made anything up just to keep it peaceful. And I think the king was wise to up to their tricks. I thought at first maybe he couldn't remember, like me, remember his dream. But no, he remembered it. He just didn't want to tell them what it was about. I think he suspected that they just made things up. So he refused to tell them. But Your Majesty, they said, no man could know. Only a mind reader, and actually only the gods could tell you what you dreamed about. Actually, they weren't far out. It was only God, the one true God, who could know our thoughts and our dreams. And actually, God sent this one, so he knew. The king was furious. I think he must have thought, what am I paying you lot for? That's it. I'm going to destroy the lot of you. You're all going to be put to death. Soldiers, round up all my advisors. Kill them. Kill them all immediately. Now remember, Daniel and his three friends, they were part of the wise men training program. And this had happened long before it had ended. And when the head soldier arrived to take Daniel, Daniel asked, what's happened? What's been going on? And when he tells him about the dream, Daniel says, give me some time and I will tell the king what he dreamt and what it meant. And the king, well, he agrees to wait. Straight away, Daniel goes to his three friends' house. Do you remember their names? Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. That night, they prayed for wisdom. They got down on their knees and asked for help to know what to do and what to say. Guys, this is my favourite bit of the whole story. What did our Bible verse say today? If you do not have wisdom, ask God for it. He is always ready to give you it. James 1 verse 5. When we need to be wise, when we need advice, God is ready to help. We just need to ask. Daniel met up with his friends and they all prayed that night. You know, guys, there's nothing better than having good friends who will pray for the things that worry you. Good friends who will pray for and with you. I know I've got a group of friends who do just that for me. In fact, one of my friends is doing that right now for this filming. Maybe you can find a couple along with your family who will be your prayer partners. The next day, Daniel goes straight to the king. He says, don't kill the wise men, stop all the killings. God has told me about your dream. You see, Daniel isn't a show off. He doesn't go and say, I know what your dreams meant, I'm very wise. He says, God has told me. That's the one thing the wise men did get right. Only God did know. Daniel said, as you lay down to sleep, you were wondering what will happen next in world history. God showed you the future by showing you a big statue. Now, I love reading history books about different empires. No, not that empire. And that was the other series. Empires and kingdoms. But what we know about are all history, things that have happened in the past. It's already being done. God was showing the king world history that hadn't even happened yet. God knows the past, the present, and the things to come. And God is in control of it all. Daniel said to the king, God showed you a huge statue. The Bible says enormous, dazzling, awesome. They're the actual words in my Bible. Now, the closest I could get to this was, well, this. Yes, I know it's a Power Ranger Megazord, but it's the best I can do. You'll just have to imagine it looked like this, or even better, this. It had a head made of gold. It had a silver chest and arms. It had brass hips and thighs, iron legs and feet made of iron and clay. Daniel said these were a picture of the empires that would come after the Babylonians. Now, he did say that the king and the Babylonians was the gold head, which pleased the king. It made him feel quite important. He was very pleased with himself. But the others are what we can see happened throughout history. Some people have been clever enough to work this out. They said the gold head is Babylon, a powerful empire, but it did not last forever. The silver, well, that's the Medes and the Persians, who were about to take over from this king, although he didn't know it. But their kingdom did not last forever. Bronze, they were the Greeks under Alexander the Great. It was a great empire, but their kingdom just did not last forever. Next, those legs of iron, the Roman Empire. They ruled all over the world, but do you know what? Their kingdom did not last forever. Then the toes and the feet. They were a mixture, weren't they, of iron and clay. That's all the kingdoms, the more modern ones, the countries that we would know today. They're all mixed. There isn't one of them who rules all over the world. But that kingdom too will not last forever. There is only one kingdom that lasts forever. It's God's kingdom. Remember that last part of the dream that you saw on Bob's video? Daniel tells the king, a rock came. That rock was Jesus. All those other kingdoms will one day be destroyed and pass away. That rock then grew, and in that dream, it turned into a mountain that covered the earth. I don't know what it's going to be like when Jesus comes again, but this is a little glimpse of what God told that king was going to happen. God knows the whole lot, guys. The past, the history, the present, today, and the future. He's in control whether world events or leaders make good decisions or bad. For those who love God and live in his kingdom, we know that kingdom never fails or ends. God, because of Jesus, has planned it that way. So the king rewards Daniel with lots of gifts, and he promotes him to be in charge of all these wise guys, to be the chief advisor. And Daniel asks for jobs for his three prayer partners too. The king gives them powers over different places in Babylon. So, can you remember last week? How many times wiser did we say that Daniel was than all the other magicians and advisors? Dan, dan, dan! 10 times. He was 10 times wiser than all the rest. So, this week we've learned God sends dreams. When we need help, when we want advice, we're to ask God, and we're to try and find people to pray with us. We've learned that God is in control. He knows what has happened, what is happening, and what will happen in the future. And all other kingdoms don't last, but God's kingdom lasts forever and ever. Amen. So don't forget, you can download the activities again from the link below, and you can get yourself some bookmarks this week. There's puzzles, there's word searches again, spot the differences, all different from last week. Cross words and also some colouring in. Oh, and also remember that craft I showed you. There was a good one on Pinterest for that. And you just had to put two cups together. But this is the one that I actually smashed to pieces with Jesus the Rock. But you can find instructions how to make that on Pinterest. So next week, we find that King Nebuchadnezzar's dream did come true. There's a new king, Belshazzar. Belshazzar the Mede. Can you remember? That was the next one down in the empires. But hey, not for long. The writing's on the wall for that guy. Quite literally. So bye. See you then.
Hey, oh, let's go.
Challenge Creed. Today's contestants, Creed versus Yard. Let's get it on.
Oi, oi, guys, and welcome back to Challenge Craig. This is the part of the show where I set you guys a challenge using everyday household objects, and you've got to try and beat my score. This week, we're doing a throwback to Easter Club, not this year, but the year before when the whole Challenge Craig started, and it's all about balancing cushions or pillars on your head. So you're going to need a stack of cushions or a stack of pillars. I've got quite a few here, and what you've got to do is put one on, get the next one, put it on, and stack it and make a big tower on your head and see how many you can get up there until they fall over, and then that's your score. So I can't remember how many I got in Easter Club, but what I'm gonna do is go like this, and that score will appear there, and let's see if I beat it this time. So here we go. Right, I'm gonna start with a gray one on the head. Another grey one. Oh. And, oh, it's wobbling already. Another grey one. No, this is a black one. Little black one. And another one. How many have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4 so far. And it's wobbly. Uh-oh. This isn't going to be a good score. A silver one this time. Here we go. Oh. Right, we're on. One thing I forgot to mention, once you get all your pillars on, it's got to stay there for 10 seconds. Oh, I don't think that would. Oh. Right, 5 so far. 1, 2, oh, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, I can go for another one. Oh, it's a bit farther away. I should have put them all closer. So 5, 6, is it on? Is it on? Yes, it's on. Here we go. Oh. 1, 2, oh. Gotta get it right. Gotta get it balanced. 1, 2. Back to 6 again. Here we go. Right, I've got to balance this time. I think. 1, 2, 3. Oh! Oh! Oh no, they're all falling. Quickly! Right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, there you have it. I guess 5 was my limit. And I don't think that's beaten last year, the Easter Club score. Anyway, give it a go. All you need is some cushions and a head. And I think everyone's got them. So we'll give it a go. Take a picture, take a video, send it to us. We'd love to see them. And if you beat us or if you don't, send them in to us. We'd love to see them. And you could be on next week's episode of This Is Awesome! Right, get up, get ready, because we're about to do some actions and some singing and some songs and some dancing about and praising God. So, what song should we have? Higher Than the Sky. I like that one, yeah. We'll have that one. And roll it!
Hey, oh, let's go!
Higher than the sky, your love is
Right, guys, that's everything for this week's ARK Online. I hope you've had a fantastic time with us. Isolating. Hopefully, we won't be isolating next week and we'll be back in the studio as normal. Have a fantastic week next week. It's your final week at school and then it's the 6 weeks holidays. I bet you cannot wait. I hope the weather's nice for you and I hope you have a smashing time with your friends for the final week. Right, I'm going to pray for us now as we leave. So get ready to do the prayer drill. One, two, three. Dear God, thank you for being in control of everything. Help us to take comfort in the knowledge that you know how everything will turn out and that you have a plan for our lives. Help us to seek wisdom from you. Be with us next week as we are going into school for our final week. Keep us safe. Keep us safe from isolations, Lord, so that we get to go in and enjoy our time with our friends. Be with us. We love you and we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, guys, see you next week. Have fun, be safe, and wash your hands. See ya! I normally walk off, but I haven't really got anywhere to go. Go up the stairs, buddies. See ya. Bye. Thanks, guys, for watching this week's episode of the ARK Online. Remember, you can watch previous episodes on our YouTube channel. Please consider subscribing to us. It helps us out greatly. And giving us a like. Don't know what that really does. It helps in some way. Maybe it helps share it out to other people. Also, give us a share on Facebook and just let people around you know that the ARK Online is happening. And we'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.